Hi friends, this is my third video on prepositions and I'm going to continue with some more prepositions that I'm going to teach you. I want you to please observe keenly and take down the notes if possible and keep learning those prepositions correctly. Okay. I have two more sections and after that I'm going to tell you the correct usage of some prepositions. What prepositions are used to talk about a reason or purpose? Answer: to talk about a reason or a purpose, we use for, with, of. Okay, let us give some examples for these three. Walking is good for health. Number one. Number two, good people live for others. For third one, Sheila trembled with fear. With fourth one, she died of cancer. So when we are talking about a reason or a purpose, then we use these kind of prepositions: for, with, of. Here, walking is good for health. Good people live for others. Sheila trembled with fear. She died of cancer. So here we see the reason or the purpose in these sentences. Now, why should we walk? To get good health, we need to walk. Good people live for others. They don't think about themselves, but they think of others and they live for them. Sheila trembled with fear. Because she is afraid, she was trembling. She died of cancer. Because she had cancer, she died of that disease. So we have reasons and purpose mentioned in these sentences. Now let's go to the next one. What prepositions are used when we talk about directions or movement, which is motion? When we talk about directions or movements, we use true. Example, the monkey climbed up the tree. Second one, the earth moves around the sun. Third one, we walked towards the temple. Towards fourth one, she jumped into the river. Here the definition says the prepositions we use are up, around, towards, into when we talk about directions, north, south, east, west, or movements. We use up, around, towards, into. In the first sentence, the monkey climbed up the tree, from the bottom of the tree to up. So here there is movement. The earth moves around the sun, that we need not understand. It is understood easily. We walked towards the temple. If there is a temple over here, we are walking towards this direction. She jumped into the river. The river is here. She is standing over here. Okay, and she is jumping. The movement or the motion. The movement is called the motion. So when there is a movement or we use these kinds of prepositions. Next topic is the correct use of some important prepositions. Okay, let's take one, at, comma, in. The preposition at is used for small places like villages, towns, a smaller locality, or for addresses. In is used for bigger places large towns, cities, states, countries, and continents. Example, I was born at Bangalore in Karnataka. Second one, The minister lives at number 112 Palace Road, Hyderabad. Third one, Miss Gulnaz lives in Uttarakhand. Fourth one, let's meet Raju at the Bangalore club this afternoon. So the definition says that we use the preposition at for smaller places and we use the preposition in at for larger places. Now let us take the first sentence. I was born at Bangalore in Karnataka. Karnataka is a state and in that place we have the capital city Bangalore. So Bangalore is smaller than Karnataka. Because Bangalore is smaller, we have used the preposition at, and because Karnataka is bigger than Bangalore, we have used in for Karnataka. Next one, the minister lives at number 112 Palace Road, Hyderabad. Now we have used at number 112. 112 is smaller than Palace Road. So we have used at this preposition at over here. Comparing these two, this is smaller than this. So we have used the preposition at over there. Miss Gulnaz lives in Uttarakhand. Uttarakhand is a big place or a new state in India, and we have used this preposition in over here. Let's meet Raju at the Bangalore club this afternoon. We have used at over here because the Bangalore club is a small place in that area. So we have used the preposition at for a smaller place. Second one is in, into. In is used to talk about rest position, rest or inside something. And position. Into indicates the movement from one point to another, to the other, it is used with the verb motion. Example, Shankar is in the room. Second one, she jumped into the well. Now, what does in say? In is used to talk about rest or inside something and position. Now, let us assume Shankar is inside the room. We don't know whether he is sitting or standing, okay? But he is inside the room. That is the position. So, here we are using the preposition in because there is no movement. He might be just sitting there or he might be just standing. She jumped into the well. Here we are using the preposition into because there is some movement. Now, for example, this is the well, okay, and she's standing somewhere over here and she's jumping into the well. So here this movement, or we call the motion, then we use into. When there is movement, we use into. When there is no movement, we use in. As simple as that. Okay. In my next video, I'm going to talk about some more important prepositions. Please click on these videos and keep observing and learning as much as possible. Friends, you may subscribe to my channel in YouTube. To subscribe, please press here. Follow me on Twitter by clicking here. Want to follow me on Facebook? Click here to like my page.